Thank you. My name is Jonathan Block. I work as a software developer at the Netherlands Institute for Sound and Vision. And I would like to tell you a bit about the Universal Viewer that we're working on with Europeana Media. The objective of this viewer is developing and integrating a state-of-the-art interoperable unified playout service for time-based media in the Europeana core platform based on open standards, such as IIIF, that supports specific types of end-user engagement and services, and experimenting and evaluating the playout service with use cases engaging end users in the education and research domains. So basically, we are developing a platform through which educators, researchers, and the general public are able to access European audiovisual content from an international array of content providers. Our technical partner in this project is Noterik, a company based in Amsterdam, as well as the members of Europeana Media and the institute I work at. These partners previously worked together on the EU Screen project, in which we created an application through which aggregated content from various European content providers could be viewed. Our approach in this project consisted of a startup phase in which we looked into the state of the art regarding standards and players. In this phase, we reached out to others in our field who were doing similar things and discussed how they were doing things. The next phase was, at the next phase, our technical partner started implementation work on the player. And in the meantime, Europeana Media added support for the player and manifests in their annotations API. And as well as at the same time, as soon as we had prototypes, we started collecting end user feedback. Here you see on the left one of our wireframes that the design was based on, as well as a demo video, but unfortunately it wasn't working from this machine, so please imagine a nice demo here. It was one of our earlier prototypes, so perhaps it's better. Our universal player is based on the IIIF universal viewer. However, our technical partner has made adjustments to the code base as per the requirements from our content providers, as well as end users. One of the most notable changes is the decoupling of the graphical design, as a number of our content providers required this. For instance, in order to display their own watermarks on the video and similar things. So that was a bit of feedback from our developers on the code base of the IIIF player. And the design of the player is too much integrated in the code base. And another bit of feedback which we worked on was that if a video was not able to be played, it would show a loading animation. And this was also an issue which was fixed by our technical partner, and we intend that once we're further with this project that we'll reintegrate our changes into the code base of the IIIF player. Here you see an illustration of our architecture. Currently, we are working with a set of test videos with annotations. Our player then retrieves the manifests for the video with the annotations and subtitles integrated in the manifest. Finally, the video is shown to the user on the player's side, including the linked annotation. The storage of annotations is also done on the side of Europeana Media, where we make use of their annotation service. And Europeana has added support in their annotation service to generate manifests from various formats of subtitles. The model can therefore remain format agnostic and is based only on IIIF standards. So what are we working on at the moment? We recently started testing with focus groups again of our end users and are collecting feedback on the player. The feedback is generally positive and mostly focused on the graphical design of the player, which we are adjusting accordingly. Furthermore, we are thinking about how to continue to add content providers and support all their respective ways of secure content playout. And as the number of content providers have very strict guidelines on how videos can be played, and this affects features such as scraping of the video files. And a final step is that the content should be aggregated on the side of Europeana Media rather than using a test set of videos. So, in summary, I hope I was able to interest you in the player we're developing at Europeana Media. And if you have any questions or comments, please come talk to me or send me an email. Thank you.